Good morning, students. We have started light lesson, and yesterday we have studied about luminous object, non-luminous objects, then transparent objects or transparent material, translucent material, and opaque material. These things we have studied. Okay. Today your homework is, I am going to give today's homework. You have studied the luminous object, non-luminous object. In that examples also you have seen. Okay. Just one thing you have to do is, in luminous objects, the examples, if you see, they are classified into two things. That is, some examples are of living or natural, and some examples you can see they are of artificial type. Okay, so I just want two examples of luminous objects which are natural and luminous objects which are artificial. Just write down two examples and you will send me. Okay, now today's topic you are going to study is reflection of light. Okay, as yesterday I have explained you the light rays. Okay, how is the light ray, how we will draw the light ray, beam of light, all this yesterday I have explained. Today we are going to study the reflection. What is reflection of light? As yesterday we know opaque material. What is opaque material? The material which doesn't allow the light to pass through. Okay, if this is my hand, and if the light is falling on the hand, it will not move behind. What happened? Either it may be absorbed into the material and convert into heat energy, or another thing is that it may reflect back. Okay, so the light, the property of light which falls on an object and reflect back, it is called as reflection of light. Okay, when the light falls on any material and it reflects back, it is called as reflection of light. And in this reflection of light, there is law. Laws are there. The light rays obeys the laws. Okay, this law is obeyed by the light rays, and that you are going to study the law of reflections. What are the law of reflections? I am going to explain you. Here you can see, as here this is a mirror. Okay, you can see this part which I have drawn. This is the shaded part, means this is the behind part of the mirror, and the front part is kept like this. Mirror is placed over here, and what happened here, you can see here incident ray. Incident ray means what? It is the ray of light which falls on the mirror, okay, or which falls on any material. The light ray which falls on any material, that is called as incident ray, or it approaches to the material. That type of ray is called as incident ray. When, as I have just now I have told you, when the light ray incident on the material, it reflects back. Okay, so what happens over here? It falls on the material, and here also it has reflected back, and the ray which has reflected after falling on the material, and that ray is called as reflected ray. Okay, because the ray has reflected now, that's why that ray is called as reflected ray. Okay, once more I will tell you, this is a mirror, this is an incident ray which has fall on the mirror, and after that it reflects, that's why this ray is called as reflected ray. And you can see the line in between which is perpendicular to the surface, it is called as normal. Okay, why the line is normal over there? As you know, incident ray, reflected ray. So this normal line is a line which is perpendicular to the surface, that's why it is called as normal. And how it is, it divides the rays. You can see incident ray this side and this side, reflected ray. When the light falls and when it reflects back, you can see a perpendicular line is drawn in between these two rays, which is perpendicular to the surface. Okay, and this line is called as normal. Understood till here? See, incident ray, normal, and reflected ray. These three conditions, if you have understood, I will go a little bit further. Here you can see this is the incident angle, or it is also called as angle of incident. How this angle of incident is formed? You can see here, when the incident ray, what happens when this incident ray falls on the mirror? Okay, you can see here, it falls on the mirror and it makes an angle with the normal. Here an angle is formed with the normal. Okay, and that angle is called as angle of incidence. And another, you can see here, this way it is reflected. So the angle which is formed by the normal and reflected ray is called as angle of reflection. Okay, So this definitions you have to write this. I want this definitions in your notebook. You will send me. I want the definition of incident ray, definition of reflected ray, definition of normal, definition of angle of incidence, and definition of angle of reflection. These definitions I want. Very simple definition is of angle of incidence. You can see the angle formed by the incident ray and the normal is called as angle of incidence. You have no need to by heart the definitions. Just keep the diagram in mind, and from this diagram you can prepare all the definitions. Okay, don't mug up the definitions. It is very simple. From this diagram you can prepare the definitions. Here angle of incidence definition is angle formed by the incident ray and the normal is called as angle of incidence, and the angle formed by the normal and reflected ray is called as angle of reflection. Okay, so see here, angle of incident is written as angle I equal to angle of incidence, angle R equal to angle of reflection. The same thing I have written over here. And what are the laws now? As you can see in the diagram, see what is the first law. I will explain. First law states that the angle of incident is always equal to angle of reflection. If you see here, you can see this both angle are equal. Okay, the angle made by this two means incident ray and normal is equal to the angle made by normal to the reflected ray. This is your first law. Always it is equal. Always this both angles are equal. That is, you can see here angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. That is angle I equal to angle R. Very, very important. This law is very, very important, and you should know this law. Okay, so this is the first law you have studied, very simple law. Now second law, you can see here incident ray, reflected ray and normal, these three lines always lies in the same plane. Okay, means a same, you know, a plane. What is a plane? Means this part. You can see this much part. This is one part. You can see all the three lines are in this face only. It is not in this side. Okay, if you see the refracted ray, refracted means what? Some rays it reflects, some part it comes outside the mirror. Okay, that is refracted ray. But here it is not such thing. All the rays you can see here, incident ray, normal ray and reflected ray, they all come in this plane only, this part. So that's why the second law of reflection is incident ray, normal and reflected ray lies in the same plane. This is the law of reflection. This law is very, very important. The normal is always perpendicular to the surface of the any material surface of here. Now mirror is taken, so it is perpendicular. Okay, and this is the law of reflection. You should know this very well. Okay, now here you can see another part, regular reflection. Okay, before going to the another topic, regular reflection, one point is there, lateral inversion. What is lateral inversion? In 6th standard you have studied this about lateral inversion. What is this? If you are standing in front of a mirror, have you seen ever how you look? If you are standing, if you are facing in the front of your mirror, you can just pick your right hand and see right hand in the mirror and just see which side it is showing in the mirror. Okay, it is a reversal of your left side into right and right side into left side. That is a just reversal. Okay, which is showing. You can see in selfie mode also camera, you can see whatever you are, how you are standing, and if you take a selfie you can see the reversal of that over there. Okay, so such type of such condition is called as lateral inversion. Okay, inverted mirror, you inverted, you can see in that. Okay, left side you can see as right and right side you can see as left. That is lateral inversion. Now we are going to see the reflection. As you have seen, we will see the types. That is regular reflection. What is regular reflection of light? In this regular reflection, same diagram I have seen here, just regular and irregular reflection, these two types are there. Again there are multiple reflection, many reflections are there, but now you are going to see this too. Regular reflection. In regular reflection, what happens? The main part is the surface. Which type of surface is considered? Okay, upon that you can say that the reflection is regular or irregular. Okay, in regular reflection, here the surface is surface which is considered here, it is the smooth surface. You can see smooth surface such as mirror, many surfaces are there. If you have seen the rough surfaces, okay, many, you can see the floor, sometimes it is not rough, okay, you can see the benches, desk which is made up of wood, there also many irregularities are there. Okay, in so what happens if the light will fall on such surface, and what happens when the light will fall on the mirrors such as such smooth surfaces, if the light will fall, what happens? Okay, so if the light falls on smooth surface, it reflects back parallelly. Means what? You can see a parallel beam of incident ray fall on the smooth surface, and similarly it reflects back smoothly. You can see the reflected rays are also parallel, as it incident parallelly, similarly it reflects back also parallelly. Okay, and as you know, as normal I have considered here, for this angle there is a normal to the surface, here also normal to the surface, here also normal to the surface, it is there. Okay, for just your understanding I have drawn this. These diagrams are very important for such types of questions, if they are. So what you have to do, you have to draw the diagram, because diagram only tells you the definitions. Okay, so first you prepare properly for the diagrams, and so no need to mug up these definitions, just go through the diagrams, you will automatically, you are able to write the definitions here. Okay, so what happens, what is the definition of this? When the light is incident on the smooth surface, it reflects back parallelly, or the reflected rays are parallel to each other, is called as regular reflection. Okay, now second is irregular reflection or diffuse reflection. Another name, diffuse reflection. Here many students get confused, because if the question is asked diffuse reflection, student get confused whether the diffuse reflection is of regular reflection or irregular reflection. So you have to know this, diffused means it is irregular reflection. Okay, now here you can see, here consider, see the surface, how it is. The surface here is the rough surface. Here it was smooth surface, here the surface is rough. There are many irregularities, you can see over here. Okay, and now here see incident ray. Incident ray is falling parallelly on the rough surface. Okay, and see how it reflects back. One ray went this side, one came back side, one in any other direction it reflected. Okay, so such type of reflection you can consider as irregular reflection or diffused reflection. Okay, understood? When the incident ray falls, it reflects in any direction, it is called as irregular or diffuse reflection of light. Okay, today's topic, it was very very important, you should learn, read this properly. Okay, and this, all the topics, laws and all, you read from the textbook. Also you have to refer the textbook. In the textbook there is one column given, angle of reflection, one in one column it is written, and in another it is written angle of reflection, angle of incident and angle of reflection. In that what you have to write, actually in your textbook it is given, a small experiment is given how to draw this. Okay, in that you, it is seen that this straight line is drawn. Actually in your textbook this image is reversed, okay, upside down image it is given, but actually the concept is same. Okay, so here you can see, as I have told you, angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. Now line you have to draw, incident and reflected. When you draw, how you will draw a normal? In that it is given, you have to use a set square. Everyone has a set square in your compass box. In that you just, you have to keep a set square over here, okay, base over here, and according to the height you will draw this normal to the surface. Okay, and just what you want to see, see suppose here angle 30, this angle I have taken 30 degree, so angle of reflection will be also 30 degree. If here I am going to take 60 degree incident ray, so reflected ray will be also 60 degree. If I will take, you cannot take more than, see as it is this half part, this part is 90 degree and this 90 degree, okay, so the angle will be will come in this range only. If here I have taken 45 degree, means this 45 degree I will take incident ray, angle of incident 45 degree, then what will be the angle of reflection? It will be also 40 degree. For such type to write this conditions, the chart is given, so you can complete the table also, and also read the textbook thoroughly till this topic. Okay, thank you.